Using TypeScript built-in types. Let us now experiment with some TypeScript syntax and the built-in data types. We will check out some of the primitive data types available in TypeScript. I'll also show you how to use let and const keyword, which we can use in TypeScript as opposed to using var in JavaScript. We will declare the variable using TypeScript type annotation and see how type inference work with the Visual Studio Code Editor and TypeScript. Null and undefined have created a lot of unforeseen bugs and errors in JavaScript. We will see how to manage this in TypeScript. We will wrap up this chapter with a look at how TypeScript allows the control flow based type analysis. Now, let us start with the basic types in TypeScript. TypeScript supports all the primitive data type available in JavaScript. It also adds a few new types to the list. Let's see what are they. TypeScript has Boolean type. These are simple true and false values. Next, we have number data type, which represents the number and floating point values, just like JavaScript. There is string data type, which supports basic text data. Same as in JavaScript, the string literals are surrounded either by single quote or double quote. TypeScript also supports the string templates, which are surrounded by the backtick character. We will see its use in the demo. TypeScript also has arrays, which again comes from the JavaScript. These are the ordered list of data. A new type which TypeScript supports is enum. Using enumeration, we can give names to a finite set of numeric values so that it becomes easy to use in our code. We will use most of these types in our demo. Few more data types that TypeScript supports are void. As the name suggests, it represents the absence of a type. We will mostly see this with functions that do not return any value. Null and undefined. This represents the absence of a value or an uninitialized value. Unlike JavaScript, we cannot assign null or undefined to a variables of other type. For example, we cannot assign a null value to a string type variable. Declaring a variable with null or undefined type allow us to assign the null or undefined values selectively only to those variables. Next, we have any type. Declaring a variable as any type lets us assign any value to a variable. This means it lets us opt out of the type checking by the compiler. This can be helpful while using a third-party JavaScript library where we are not sure of the type back from a library function. Now let us see how to declare variables in TypeScript. JavaScript has allowed the usage of a variable even before declaring it, like this. Here, I have logged the variable first and then assigned the value to it. This gives no error in JavaScript. This is valid because of JavaScript hoisting at runtime. Hoisting means JavaScript effectively moves all variable declarations to the top of the code block in which they are declared. However, this will generate a TypeScript compiler error. Hadn't we said that a valid JavaScript code is a valid TypeScript code? Well, not in this case. Here, the TypeScript compiler will generate the error even before it reaches the JavaScript engine to run the code. Let me show you this in the editor, how it works for TypeScript. So here I'm continuing with the app which we had created in our previous chapter. Let's see the demo in the main.ts file itself. When I use the same code that we had seen in the slide that was used for JavaScript, here I immediately get an error. It says variable myString is used before being assigned. So this does not work in TypeScript. However, we can use var to declare the variable and then use it. So if I move this console statement after the variable declaration, this works totally fine for me. We can similarly declare a variable using let in the same way as we have used var. So here I'm using let to declare the variable myString2. Declaring constants also work the same way. We need to use const keyword instead of let. Now here myString3 has the value hello world and it is declared using const keyword. If I try to reassign this variable with some other value, I'll get an error. Here you can see, cannot assign to myString3 because it is constant. I'll just remove this. Now the basic difference between var, let and const is that with var, the variables are globally scoped or function scoped. That is, if it is declared inside a function, it is available only within the function. If outside a function, they are global variables. Whereas variables with let and const are block scoped. The block may be a if block, try catch block, for block or any code block. It can be used only in the block where they are declared. With var and let, we can declare a variable even without initializing it. However, with const, we need to initialize the variable when we declare it. The value of the variable can be changed when declared with var and let, whereas it should never change when declared with const. We will mostly use let and const in the demo in this course. Since these are block scoped, it becomes easy to track the variables, debug and prevent the errors. Let us now have a look at type annotations and type inference in TypeScript.